This is the police general hospital in central Bangkok, where Taksin Shinawat was admitted just after midnight on Wednesday morning. Showing symptoms of high blood pressure and low oxygen levels, the corrections department assessed he'd be better monitored here. For Taksin, a temporary reprieve from his first night in jail. His political allies were having a better night. Srettha Thavisin, nominated by the Pheu Thai political party and endorsed by parliament as Thailand's 30th prime minister.
I would like to thank every Thai, the coalition parties, honourable members of parliament and senators for taking part in the vote today.
For many Thais, their new prime minister is relatively unknown. A real estate magnate, he only entered politics last year. Running on a joint ticket for Pheu Thai with Taksin's daughter, Petong Tan, it was never clear who was the prime ministerial pick. When the party came second in May's general election, Srettha became the default choice.
On two fronts, Srettha himself doesn't have political backing from being in politics and his own power base. And then the party he's working for, Pheu Thai, doesn't have as much leverage as it used to in the past.
The new prime minister will also have to manage a complicated coalition government, including three military-backed parties. The inclusion of those parties will be unpopular with voters who overwhelmingly chose parties of reform at the ballot box. And those parties may pay a heavy price for their cooperation.
With all eyes here at the police hospital on the condition of former Prime Minister Taksin Shinawat, it perhaps takes a little bit of the pressure off the new Prime Minister. But he faces an uphill task with a difficult coalition to manage and a voting public who didn't necessarily choose him for the job. Tony Cheng, Al Jazeera, Bangkok.